It's February 7th, 2013, and this is a special edition of the Energy Education Podcast. I'm Kevin Hurley. Some breaking news today. A recent letter signed by Senator Barbara Boxer and Congressman Markey is calling on the NRC to conduct an investigation into the operator of the San Onofre nuclear power plant, Southern California Edison. The letter refers to a recently leaked document from Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, which shows that Southern California Edison was in fact aware of the dangers involving their design changes and quietly sidestepped the proper licensing process. Of course, these design changes resulted in failed steam generator tubes and the potential for a much more serious threat to the public safety. Joining us now to discuss this breaking news, Arnie and Maggie Gundersen.
Thanks for having us, Kevin.
Hi, Kevin.
What is going on with San Onofre? What is this letter released by Barbara Boxer all about?
There are just several quotes from a specific report written by Mitsubishi Heavy Industries that shows that Edison did not make changes, that safety changes that were appropriate to its design, redesign of the replacement steam generators, because it would have made the NRC take a closer look, and they did not want the NRC to look. Unfortunately, that report has not been released to the public. I called Congressman Markey's office yesterday and asked if it was being released, and his office informed me that it had trade secrets, and therefore it could not be released to the general public.
You know, that argument that there's trade secrets in this report, that's just a smokescreen on the part of the Nuclear Regulatory Commission. They don't want to release this report, apparently. You know, when this tube started to leak last year, Edison invited in all of Mitsubishi's competitors to analyze and discover what went wrong with Mitsubishi's design. So Mitsubishi has no trade secrets to hide from the nuclear industry. The only people that Mitsubishi has secrets to hide from are the public. And last time I knew, we were not in the business of building steam generators. So this argument that the Nuclear Regulatory Commission is saying, well, we can't release the report because it'll jeopardize Mitsubishi's competitive position in the market. You know, frankly, I think that the condition of the steam generators at San Onofre is going to do more to ruin their competitive position than any release of a document would to the public. We have a right to know, and I hope there's an ask here for anybody who's listened to this is call Senator Boxer's office and say we want that report. The public has a right to know. You know, let's put this thing in historical perspective. In 2003, Edison put together a specification for a new steam generator. And in it, they said that they did not want to involve a Nuclear Regulatory Commission. And whoever won the award had to sign that they would push the analysis in such a way that the Nuclear Regulatory Commission would never be involved.
So they were basically saying that the design changes weren't going to be significant enough to warrant them having to inform the NRC.
That's right. Before they did the design changes, they made the decision that the design changes were not going to be significant enough to tell the NRC. I think what this letter to the NRC from Boxer and Markey shows is that way back when this thing was being designed, there were warnings from Mitsubishi that Edison did not want to accept. So apparently both Edison and Mitsubishi knew a long time ago that this generator was problematic. And yet they went ahead and fabricated it and then built it and then delivered it and then ran it, and it broke. It broke in less than 2 years. In one case, one of them broke in 10 months. And the reason it broke is because Edison didn't want to use the public licensing process. It wanted to do this with a stealth approach to steam generator design and to keep the public out.
So if the public has not been made privy to these documents, what else can we tell about the documents based on the Markey Boxer letter?
Well, the letter has a couple of excerpts from the report, and they strongly suggest that there were prior warnings that were ignored. And the only reason they were ignored wasn't that these were great ideas or bad ideas, but because if Edison accepted the warnings, it would have had to open the process to public participation. It would have had to have a license amendment. So you know, now we have Edison saying, well, safety is our number one priority. But in fact, since 2004, their number one priority was to keep the public and the Nuclear Regulatory Commission out of the process.
Yeah, I think it goes even farther than that. It shows that Edison covered up the truth. They knew this. They were asked about it. Fairewinds issued a report in March of 2012 that talked about the fact that Edison made design changes and purposefully left that information out from any of its NRC filings because it didn't want to face a license amendment process. And according to the quotes extracted from the MHI report that Senator Boxer and Congressman Markey have, that is verified. It's verified in there, and it says that they purposely took this action because they didn't want a full license amendment review. I don't know. Does that constitute lying under oath? To me, it does.
And of course, you could say now, since they did avoid that process and they did have that accident, they knowingly put the public safety in Southern California at risk?
Yes. There are 8.5 million people right in that vicinity of the nuclear plant, inadequate evacuation plans. And the ratepayers have paid more than $770 million for this debacle of these broken, faulty design replacement steam generators.
This doesn't seem like the type of document that Mitsubishi would want to release.
This report wasn't released publicly by Mitsubishi. Apparently, the NRC has had this document since October, and the NRC hasn't released it either. Some brave whistleblower, contacted Representative Markey and Senator Boxer and provided the report to them. So I think there's a deep debt of gratitude that the public owes to somebody who contacted Boxer and Markey.
All right. Well, that about does it for this special edition podcast. Arnie, Maggie, thanks for coming on the show again.
Thanks for having us, Kevin.
Thank you, Kevin.
Just as a reminder, these documents are available at the Fairewinds website. The address is www.fairewinds.org. Fairewinds is spelled with an E. Also, don't forget to like us on Facebook. For Fairewinds Energy Education, I'm Kevin Hurley. Thanks for listening.